Everybody knows in Las Vegas that you can see a glitzy show and maybe a star or two, but here in Red Rock Canyon, just down the road a spill, when the sun goes down, well, you get to see a whole different kind of show. And trust me, it's out of this world.
The legendary lights of Las Vegas create a spectacle unmatched anywhere in the world. A dome of light that can be seen for 200 miles in all directions. But there's something you can't see in the city that's even more breathtaking.
Yeah, I want you to meet Greg. He's the president of the Las Vegas Astronomical Society. Nice seeing you, Greg.
Nice to see you too.
Hey, tell me about your club.
Well, the club started in the early 80s. We have about 140 active members and about 2,500 followers that follow us on our Facebook page.
And you guys meet a lot. Tell me about that.
We meet once a month at the College of Southern Nevada's Cheyenne campus in the planetarium.
Greg McKay and the Astronomical Society have shared their love of astronomy for over 35 years. They provide not only information, but the tools and technology needed for those wanting to explore the undiscovered country.
How'd you get into this?
I got into it when I was about 11 or 12 years old. I found a telescope in my parents' attic and dusted the cobwebs off of it and was observing the moon for a couple of nights and was about to commit the telescope back to the cobwebs and saw this bright object rising above my neighbor's house. And I pointed the telescope at it and it was Saturn. And seeing Saturn in this little bitty tiny telescope, and I was hooked from that day forward.
I remember the moment I first saw Saturn myself in my backyard. It's just magical.
It is.
Most people miss out on the joy of seeing a celestial body and don't even realize it. Astronomers today estimate that light pollution prevents the visibility of the Milky Way across over 80% of the Earth's landmass. If you want to see the heavens, you're going to need help from the experts.
Well, you know, we're really fortunate. Even though we live right here in Las Vegas, it seems like the light pollution capital of the world. You only have to drive 15 or 20 minutes outside of the city limits to get to beautiful places like Red Rock here and have just fantastic views of the night sky.
What are some of the things that people would see tonight if they came out?
Well, telescope is pointing at Venus right now. Everybody's had a chance to take a peek at Venus, and we're impressed with that. We've got the moon up tonight. There's a few other brighter nebulas and galaxies and stuff that are visible even from, this close to the city.
The Las Vegas Astronomical Society holds some impressive celestial shindigs. The monthly star parties are open to the public, allowing rookie stargazers to dip their toes into the cosmic ocean. The last few meetups have hosted more than 2,000 attendees.
I get a thrill every single night I set this telescope up, even if it's just in my backyard and I'm looking at something that I've looked at 1,000 times before, just to know that I'm looking at it, right then and right there. And it's not a picture in a book, it's not on the internet, it's just the real thing.
Can I see Venus?
Absolutely.
All right, I'm gonna take a look.
Take a look.
Yep, she's still there. Everything's good, everything's good.
With one view, just like that, I'm a kid again, discovering space for the first time. The Society's work to preserve that feeling of youthful wonder in the world all comes together with a simple glance at the night sky.
Greg, I know you got a Society to look after, but I just want to take a second to say thanks for having us out tonight.
Our pleasure.
All right, we're going to take a second and just let the sky get dark, let the stars come out, and then we're going to see what we can see.
Besides Venus, I take a look at Mars and Jupiter. I get to see globular clusters and nebulas that shine faintly over the valley lights. On the hunt to spot my next celestial body, I see Orion and his sword. Of the seven stars that compose the constellation, all of them are among the most distant stars that can be seen with the naked eye. Orion shines 1,344 light years from the Earth, and it will keep its shape long after most other constellations.
You know, an interesting thing happened tonight. When I was looking up at the stars, it was like I became a kid again in my backyard. And I guess that's a good reminder for me, and I hope it is for you too, to enjoy the best parts of Nevada. Sometimes you just gotta look up.